The greater Memphis area sits within the New Madrid seismic zone, which is one of the most seismically active and also capable of producing major earthquakes. So there's no better time than now to be prepared for the next big quake. The following portion of Live at 9 is sponsored by the Central United States Earthquake Consortium. And Brian Blake is their executive director here to talk about this. So welcome. And what is Shakeout earthquake drill?
So the Great Shakeout earthquake drill is an international earthquake drill. It takes place every October on the third Thursday in October, and it's a time where we offer citizens, communities, businesses, schools, etc., kind of a dedicated time to practice what to do during an earthquake, how to stay safe, and then how they might respond and recover afterwards too.
And this is so important because we have people on this seismic on the fault line. Mm-hmm. Some places don't have the people on it. So tell us, how can people prepare to survive and recover from an earthquake?
So during an earthquake, it's important that you protect your body, right? Uh-huh. Especially your head and your neck. So you want to drop, cover, and hold on. That means drop to the ground, cover your head and your neck, and hold on until the shaking stops. If possible, you can get under a table or a desk or something like that if it's nearby. But you don't want to run during an earthquake because you could be thrown down to the ground and injured. And you really want to try and get as low as possible and protect your vital organs. And if you can't drop, cover, and hold on, you still want to try and make yourself as low as possible. So we say, if you can't get up after getting down on the ground, don't get down. Just try and make yourself as low as possible.
Don't get up to get down.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so wait, what's a bug out bag? I love this name, but it sounds scary.
Yeah, so this is one thing you could have in the event of an earthquake or even any other disaster. It's a bug out bag or a grab and go bag, which might have some essential things that you need in it. First aid kit, hand warmers, a bottle of water, some dehydrated food there. You could have things like a flashlight. Mm-hmm. We've got an emergency go kit passport, which we have at our office, and anybody can contact us for those. And with this, you can fill out information that's important, like your emergency contacts, your insurance broker, and those sorts of things, in case you need to contact those groups.
All right, we're running out of time, but we have to know, any lessons that we learned from recent hurricanes in the southeast?
Right. So we know that, those hurricanes came, there was a little warning. We don't get a lot of warnings with earthquakes, but there was widespread impacts and people were impacted almost immediately. They had to get out in some cases really fast. So it's just important to be prepared. A lot of people are still on their own without power, electricity, water, and internet and things like that. So they kind of need to, everyone needs to be prepared to survive an earthquake or other disaster for at least 2 weeks.
All right, Brian's bug out bag. Thank you so much for coming. And the preceding portion of Live at 9 is sponsored by the Central United States Earthquake Consortium. Thank you.